You're watching our special series, The Seven Wonders of India, where you help us choose the seven wonders. Welcome to the Nalanda University, the first residential international university in the world.
Nalanda mein aapka swagat hai. Mera naam Wayne Sound aur aaj main aapka saathi. Aaj se lagbhag 1500 saal pehle maine Nalanda mein kai varsh guzare. तो चलिए नालंदा में प्रवेश करने की कोशिश करते हैं। अंदर प्रवेश पाने के लिए इनका उचित जवाब देना जरूरी है। 10 प्रवेशार्थियों में से केवल 2 या 3 लोगों को ही प्रवेश मिलता था।
ब्राह्मण कौन होता है और उसका जन्म से क्या तात्पर्य?
ब्राह्मण वो होता है जो ऊंचे कर्म करता है और जो घमंड न करता, जो संसार को समझने की कोशिश करता और जन्म से उसका कोई वास्ता नहीं।
When the guards at Nalanda were so knowledgeable, imagine how brilliant the teachers were. Like thousands of scholars from across Asia, Yuan Sang had made an arduous journey to ancient Magadha in the 7th century in search of what was then the world's most influential seat of learning. Stayed here for 3 years studying Yoga Shastra under legendary Buddhist scholar Shilabhadra, also the Chancellor of Nalanda. In Yuan Sang's records, this was a flourishing university of a monastic order where 1500 teachers and over 10,000 students lived. King Ashok and Harshvardhan are some of its most celebrated patrons who constructed monasteries and temples here. Yuan Sang, the Chinese pilgrim, has written ecstatic accounts of the ambience and the architecture of this university. He says it's a unique university. Of course, Yuan Sang studied here, but other than that, Nalanda University boasts of an illustrious list of alumni. Nagarjuna, the 2nd century famous philosopher, Aryadev, as well as Shilabhadra are just a few of them. Rigorous in its scholarship, Nalanda was the cradle of Buddhist civilization. Earliest references of Nalanda can be traced back in Magadha to the time of Gautama Buddha in the 6th century BC. The complex was magnificently and meticulously planned. According to another Chinese scholar, Ai Singh, who spent 10 years in Nalanda, there were 8 monastic buildings and over 300 apartments. The apartment was small rectangular cells serving as single and double seated rooms for students. Monks' cells were spread on all the 4 sides. In one section, we see an octagonal well in a corner, evidence of a community kitchen and dining area. We also see proofs of a personal locker system, effective drainage, and granaries. Each monastic building had its own temple. In these impressive lecture halls, 3 layers of construction are clearly visible, indicating distinct periods of rulers of Ashok, Harshvardhan, and the Pala kings. A walk in the ruins of this university reminds you of the golden period of India in the field of art and architecture, literature and learning. India was looked upon as a principal center of learning, and Nalanda was one of its most important centers. Logic, grammar, medicine, philosophy, religion, all of it was taught here. To study or to have studied here in Nalanda was a matter of great prestige. Freshers were lectured under the guidance of teachers, but more advanced students worked in smaller groups. In advanced courses, there are even references of 1 teacher per student. After graduating, the scholars went to the king's courts for appointments. Many were invited to countries like Ceylon, China, Tibet, Java, and Korea for translation works, establishing monasteries or royal consultations. Many others traveled out to propagate Buddhism, like Padmasambhav, a teacher of yoga and occult sciences. He went to Tibet, where he established the first monastery and became the founder of Lamaism.
It is said that Nalanda was a very prosperous temple city during the time of Buddha. Whenever Buddha visited Nalanda, he resided in a mango grove. This is the site of that mango grove. Buddha stayed here and gave his sermons. Later, a stupa was erected here in the memory of Sariputra. Sariputra was one of the five principal disciples of Buddha. And later, Ashoka built a temple here. And this is definitely the most assuming and most beautiful of the various temples at the Nalanda University. It is decorated with beautiful stucco terracotta images of Buddha.
This is the Sariputra stoop, the most ornate temple here. Surrounded by smaller stupas, a stairway leads to the top, offering a bird's eye view of the grand university. It was in 1915, archaeologists began excavating these ruins. Now, nearly 100 years later, leaders in Asia are trying to excavate a future vision for Nalanda. Drawn by its legacy of Buddhist learning, Asian nations, China, Japan, Singapore, and others, want to help India rebuild an international university at Nalanda. If you value this priceless possession of India's Buddhist heritage, vote for Nalanda as the Seven Wonders of India.